Hey there, viewers. Whenever we talk about heart health, cholesterol is usually mentioned. A lot of people think cholesterol is bad for you. Is this true? Well, yes and no. It's a fairly complex topic. While high cholesterol can lead to health problems, it's a certain type you need to watch out for. In today's video, we'll be discussing cholesterol in detail. What is it? Should you be afraid of it? What kind of cholesterol is the bad kind? How do you increase good cholesterol and lower the bad? Can you lower cholesterol levels through your diet? We'll be talking about all of these and more. What is cholesterol? Cholesterol is one of the words you hear when talking about health, especially when it comes to the heart. You've probably been told that high cholesterol is bad for your heart and you need to bring down the levels. Well, it's a little more complicated than that. Technically speaking, cholesterol is a kind of lipid. This is a substance that is fat-like and is produced naturally by your liver. Cholesterol is actually a very important substance, as it helps create cell membranes, vitamin D, and several important hormones. Cholesterol is supposed to circulate in your bloodstream, but since it does not dissolve in water, cholesterol cannot travel on its own. To help with that, your liver also produces something called lipoproteins. These are a combination of fat and protein. There are two major types, low-density lipoprotein, LDL, and high-density lipoprotein, HDL. The health issues related to cholesterol are caused by LDL cholesterol, or bad cholesterol, as it's referred to. When you're told your cholesterol levels are high, the doctor is referring to LDL cholesterol. If your blood has too much LDL cholesterol, it can lead to heart attacks and strokes. Considering there are no symptoms to diagnose high cholesterol, it's necessary that you get regular checkups done. Do you get your cholesterol checked often? What results did you get last time? What are you doing to improve your cholesterol? Sound off in the comment section and start a conversation with our bestie community. LDL cholesterol or bad cholesterol. LDL is mainly responsible for carrying cholesterol to your arteries. When there's too much LDL, it could end up forming cholesterol walls around your arteries. This is known as cholesterol plaque. What this plaque does is make your arteries more narrow. This in turn means there's much less blood flow and increases the chances of blood clots. The danger of a blood clot is that it can block your heart's artery or even the brain itself. This leads to heart attack or stroke. It's said that a third of American adults have high levels of LDL cholesterol. It's imperative that you get your cholesterol levels checked so that you're not falling into this category. HDL cholesterol or good cholesterol. The main advantage of HDL cholesterol is that it acts to remove the harmful effects of LDL. HDL can either return LDL cholesterol back to the liver or get rid of it from your body completely. This way, HDL cholesterol makes sure there's no formation of cholesterol plaque, resulting in less chances of blood clots, heart attacks, or strokes. That's a relief, right? Looking for answers on all the latest health and wellness news? Hit that subscribe button and join our millions of followers. Stay up to date on all our great bestie content. Getting your cholesterol levels checked. According to experts, everyone over 20 years of age should check their cholesterol levels once every 4 to 6 years. As you grow older, the frequency of checkups needs to increase as well. If you have a history of high cholesterol, your doctor might suggest more frequent checkups. The way your doctor checks cholesterol is by using a lipid panel. This measures the levels of LDL and HDL in your blood. The total cholesterol value you get is a combination of both LDL and HDL types in your bloodstream. When your LDL cholesterol is too high or your total cholesterol is at a higher than normal level, your doctor will diagnose you with high cholesterol. In the case of high total cholesterol, it's important to take the proper measures. This is on the chance you have very high LDL and very low HDL. Causes of high cholesterol. One of the obvious reasons for high cholesterol is eating foods that have high cholesterol content. If you're constantly eating saturated and trans fats, your chances of high cholesterol go up. Other factors involve lifestyle choices. If you're an avid smoker, you increase the chance of high cholesterol in your blood. If you're consistently sitting on your butt doing no physical activity, that can also be one of the reasons. Another aspect that can affect your cholesterol levels is your genetic makeup. If your mom or dad suffered from high cholesterol, chances are you'll have the same problem. Some genes have an instruction manual that tells your body how to process cholesterol and fats. One of the rare cases related to genetics and cholesterol is familial hypercholesterolemia. Whew! This particular disorder doesn't allow your body to get rid of the LDL. According to research, those with this genetic disorder display total cholesterol levels of more than 300 milligrams per deciliter and LDL levels of over 200 milligrams per deciliter. For reference, high cholesterol is diagnosed when you have total cholesterol levels above 200 milligrams per deciliter and LDL levels over 130 milligrams per deciliter. High cholesterol can also be acting as the collateral effect of other health conditions you have, such as diabetes and hypothyroidism. Before we move ahead, here's another video you might like to watch. Your body's immunity also plays an important role in boosting your health. Watch and learn more about 7 natural ways to boost your immunity. Now back to our discussion on cholesterol. Risk factors for high cholesterol. There are certain risk factors you need to check up on to make sure you don't fall into the high cholesterol category. For instance, if you're overweight or obese, the chances are very likely you also have high cholesterol. Similarly, people who don't exercise or eat healthy are very much at risk of high cholesterol. An unhealthy lifestyle will cause your LDL to skyrocket, so try your best to switch up your daily routine. Lowering cholesterol through diet. There are a few dietary changes you can do to lower your cholesterol. Eating foods such as chicken, fish, and legumes can be helpful. These are all lean sources of protein. Your diet should always include lots of fruits, veggies, and whole grains. These foods are rich in fiber, which can help bring down cholesterol. You must also skip out on fried food. Sorry, fast food lovers. Instead, eat baked, broiled, or steamed. It goes without saying that fast food and junk food are complete no-nos. Some foods are particularly high in cholesterol and bad fats. These include red meat, organ meats, egg yolks, and high-fat dairy products. If you're always eating processed foods made with cocoa butter, palm oil, or coconut oil, you're raising your cholesterol levels without even knowing it. Deep-fried foods such as fried chicken, potato chips, and onion rings should be avoided. Cookies and muffins can also be a bit of a problem when it comes to controlling your cholesterol. Fish is particularly helpful when reducing your cholesterol. This is thanks to its omega-3 fatty acids, which bring down your LDL. If you're not keen on seafood, there are other options like walnuts, almonds, and avocados, which are rich in omega-3 fatty acids. Eating them will also help reduce your LDL levels. Your cholesterol levels are directly linked to your heart health, particularly heart attacks. But there are other things you need to know if you want to prevent heart attacks. For instance, your body gives off tiny signals months before an actual heart attack strikes. There are plenty of foods you can eat to help prevent one. Let's take a look at a couple more videos, shall we? Check out 8 signs your body gives you a month before a heart attack. You can also try our video on foods that clean your arteries and can prevent a heart attack. Go ahead, click one, or better yet, watch both and learn more about how to avoid a heart attack. Are you trying to bring your cholesterol levels down? Let us know in the comments below.